One of the three main assumptions we need in instrumental variables analysis is relevance. A common issue in practice is that we have an instrument that is relevant, so it does affect the treatment, but the causal effect is pretty small. In this case, we say the instrument is weak, or we have a weak instrument. And this is a problem because it means that the instrument doesn't induce very much variation in treatments, since it just doesn't affect them very much. But we need variation in treatments if we want to learn about causal effects. So in practice, this means that when we get estimates of causal effects using weak instruments, typically there's going to be a lot of uncertainty associated with those estimates, even if our sample sizes are pretty large. So our confidence intervals are going to be big, and it's just going to be tough to tell, statistically speaking, if there's an actual true causal effect or if we just need more data. Now, as far as assessing causality goes, you know, can we actually draw causal conclusions in this situation? Weak instruments aren't really a problem if we had large enough sample sizes. The problem arises because our sample sizes in practice just often aren't large enough to overcome this problem. And that means if you have just one instrument that's very weak, you're going to have big confidence intervals, and you're just not going to know if there's causal effects or not. So what can you do in this case? Well, unfortunately, there sometimes isn't much you can do. You're going to have to look for a different instrument that isn't weak, that's much stronger, or just use a different causal inference method altogether.